Hello, everybody, and welcome to Olajev Watchworks. So this is where we left off last time. And today, we're going to be reassembling this Jacot pivot polisher. I'm going to start by first threading the line onto this thimble. Now, this did take a couple different attempts, but finally, by keeping tension onto the string, I was able to push the thimble into place. There we go. Now this thimble's important because it allows you to not need to use the bow. That looks a little difficult. And so the advantage it gives you is, as you see here, when you pull on the string, it rewinds itself back. So this seems to be functioning correctly. Nice. Now it's time to put in the screw that holds the assembly in place. If you'll remember from the first video, I forgot to remove this screw, but I was able to polish the thimble and everything is fine. So I'm not going to put too much tension on this at the moment. And on to the next step. We have this threaded shaft that allows you to change the position of the headstock, and I'm going to put a little oil on this because I don't plan to take it back apart to make a video. There we have it. All right, now here's the disc that will connect to the headstock that threaded shaft is going to move back and forth. Now this is one of the more difficult pieces, or more difficult steps to put together. There we go. Now it's important that that stays square and straight. And there we have it. Okay. Now I want to work this thread forward and backwards to make sure that my oil is evenly distributed. And the screw that can lock this shaft, should you want to. And next are these components. I'm not sure what the name is, but what it does, they will push down onto either spindle, holding it into position. So we'll call them spindle locking widgets. And this screw is fighting me here just a little bit, but a little bit of patience, and there we have it. Now I won't tighten this all the way just yet. I want to have some pressure from above with a spindle in first. So these are going to be tacked in, for lack of a better term. And here comes the thumb screw. Now this will push down onto our bracket and hold the spindle in its position. There we have it. And here is a spindle. Now this would hold the pivot. And now I'm adding some pressure from the thumb screw, pressing down onto the spindle. And now I will tighten this screw The reason I wanted to do it this way is because I didn't want pressure from that smaller screw fighting the larger thumb screw. Now, I think it would have pushed it eventually, but I think this is the way to do it. So here comes the headstock, and what you have to do is carefully slide it over the headstock alignment disc. And next, we will thread the string over the headstock. There we have it. Bumped the camera there a little bit. I apologize for that. Okay. So that side's ready to go. And when I tighten and loosen the threaded shaft below, it can reposition that headstock onto the shaft. So now that we have some pressure from the top, I'm going to tighten this lower screw. And I didn't have a vise to put this in, so I thought, well, let's 3D print a base. So I hopped onto Fusion and drew this. And I will be putting that on Thingiverse, should you have a similar situation. And I printed mine on about 25% infill and had these cavities to catch any gear wheels that want to try to fly away. I see a lot of people were using paper and a V-shape to catch, but I like this design. So after printing it, and a couple test fits, I'm happy with this. So, let's see how she moves. Very nice. And you can see that the thimble is aligning that thread nicely. Okay. So, after a little test run and brushing back up on our watch repairs manual by Henry B. Ford, I highly recommend it. I think it's time to see what we can do. So step one is we should measure our pivot to know what position on the spindle we should use. So in this case, it's a little difficult to tell for you, the viewer, but I've got a 40 micron pivot. So I will then find the 40 micron pivot position. Make sure that it's set to the top. And after, I will engage both the holding spindle and the aligning spindle. And it seems to me that a lot of people will either use this in a left-handed orientation or a right-handed orientation, but I found that if I turn the pivot polisher perpendicular to how it normally is used, it was easier for me to get good results, and the results speak for themselves here. Look at that. Terrible. You can see a groove worn into the pivot, and after we polish it, the groove goes away. So the purpose of this is to recondition pivots, to reduce friction, and to extend the life of the pivot. And this was the worst one I could find, and it came out okay. So if you can find one of these, I highly recommend picking one up and putting it to work. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it.